Well, the initial overall cause was to preserve the Union. But then after that, it became slavery too. But although slavery was in the background the whole time. I mean, the election of 1860 had four presidential candidates. Lincoln actually didn't get a majority of the votes cast, but the thing is, all four candidates got votes.
I didn't realize that.
And but Lincoln and the Republicans were formed as the anti-slavery party.
Ah.
Because that party didn't start until 1856.
Yeah.
So leading into there, so Lincoln was the anti-slavery candidate because he was a Republican candidate. I mean, it's interesting, there's a story about Gettysburg. There was a guy who spoke at Gettysburg prior to Lincoln for 2 hours. His name was Edward Everett Horton.
Why do I know that name?
Well, it's similar to another guy who was on television years ago. But anyway, at least I think I've got his name right. Edward Everett. It doesn't have the Horton on it. That's right, it's Edward Everett.
Oh.
Everett was one of the four people that ran for president in 1860. So, but he spoke for 2 hours prior to Lincoln. Lincoln spoke for 5 minutes, and everybody remembers Lincoln's speech. Nobody remembers anything that he said.
Wow.
That's how effective the Gettysburg Address is, if you've ever read it.
You know, it makes me want to read it now.
Yep. I'll tell you, really, in a way, you should read it, because it is an astounding speech, or else listen to it. Ken Burns' series, they go over it, naturally.
And I'm going to have to get that series. Maybe I should just buy it. I bet I could get it on eBay.
Mm-hmm. Of course, there's probably segments of it on YouTube, but the thing is, you'd be watching segments and it'd be all split up. I don't think there's any whole gathering of it.
No.
It's the 29th New York Infantry Regiment.
Look at that desk.
Old 27th. Huh. Pratt. Vandervoort. Yeah, some of the names are familiar. Wouldn't be surprised if there's some descendants still around.
That's amazing. 1861.
Mm-hmm.
The old photography.
Yeah.
What a tremendous loss of life.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. A whole generation of men were practically killed, annihilated in that war.
Awful. Why,
the clothing has changed so much. The size of the people has changed, for that matter. I mean, the folks weren't built as big back then.
Right. Yeah, that's true.
You can tell that now when you look at the relics and stuff. Say, you know, like this jacket wouldn't fit most people today. Only a few people would fit.
Hysterical. Unbelievable.
They really put together quite a thing here. This is great.
It reminds me of all of the ways I see all the stuff.
Mm-hmm. People died in the thousands. They show Spotsylvania there. 31,820 people killed. Yeah, it was on the wall there. There's 17,000 in Cold Harbor. Killed, wounded, or missed. 31,000 there. Well, you realize, if you've ever heard of Pickett's Charge at Gettysburg,
mm-hmm.
1 hour, 10,000 people died.
It's how terrible.
Yeah. I mean, a whole bunch of Confederates charged across the open field, and basically the whole Confederate army was killed in that charge.
It's
kind of ironic now, within 100 yards of that is Pickett's Buffet.
Oh, that's morbid.
It is morbid.
That is terrible.
But honest to God, yeah, I actually went to Pickett's Buffet.
I wonder who dreamed that.
I don't know.
Wow. That's too much.
Yeah.
Historical society. Where is their society that they have all these things? Where's Broome County's society?
I don't know where they locate their stuff.
It's in here.
I mean, a lot of this is from the Historical Society. I'm seeing that on all this Broome County Historical Society, but I don't know where they keep their materials offhand.
Gosh.
Mm.
did a beautiful display.
Actually, if you're into the paranormal, supposedly Gettysburg has a lot of ghost stories.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Of course, we took the magic walk with the Boy Scout troop 1 year, and that's where we walked from the Confederate positions, which was called Seminary Ridge. We walked over to the high water mark of Cemetery Ridge through the battlefield at midnight.
Did you?
And it's funny because there's an eerie mist over the grass and stuff at that time of night when we walked there. This was in July, which is when it happened. Actually, the battle happened around July 4th.
Chills.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. It's quite a walk. But the thing is, with a Boy Scout troop, we could do that. I don't know general public if they allow people to do that, but you know, it was one of the great experiences for the Scout troop.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure.
You know?
But that happened to camera.
Is that where they would put the black thing over their... photographer would put the black thing over their head and take
the
picture?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is Matthew Brady type equipment. He was the most famous photographer of the Civil War. Let's see, this one here is a panoramic camera. Well, actually, this one says 1870. Or wait, one of them is 1860. One camera is actually post-Civil War, 1870. The other one's 1860. And then, more of these photos.
Look at that, one of these. Oh, daguerreotypes. I've heard of those, yeah. Wow. My gosh. Unbelievable. Civil War period photographs.
For the benefit of the soldiers at barrack number one. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I could read that, but man, it would take a while.
Oh yeah, I can't make it out.
Yeah, I got my bifocals on.
My eyes have gotten terrible. I gotta get another eye exam. Look at this. Oh, this is the old photographer's cart.
Yeah, it says Matthew Brady on it, but I don't know if that's original. Because Matthew Brady was the most famous of the Civil War photographers.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, and that's when they used glass negatives.
Yeah, look at that. Wow.